Hello everyone and welcome back to my playlist of biochemistry. Today we are going to start chapter number 15, which is about metabolism of amino acids. So basically, jo protein ki metabolism hai, that is the topic of discussion. And obviously, like other chapters that we have been doing in biochemistry, it's a long chapter. So we will curtail our discussion into divided videos. Today I'm going to focus on the general concept, which is about the amino acid pool in the body. So we'll discuss about ke jo general considerations hai wo kya hai, and then we'll carry from there. So proteins, you know, वैसे इससे भी पहले ना ये yellow box मुझे अच्छा लगता है सत्या नारायण का. We transaminate and deaminate to liberate ammonia. So that's what we do. We are doing a lot of transamination, we are doing a lot of deamination, and ammonia is produced at the end, and this ammonia is then detoxified in the liver to end product urea, which obviously you get rid from the body. So greatly important to the body are our nitrogen products. Carbon skeleton is for glucose, fat or fuel. So these yellow boxes at the beginning of each chapter in biochemistry Satya Narayana textbook, they're pretty interesting. They give you a basic idea of what's happening. Okay, proteins, you know, are the most abundant organic compounds and constitute a major part of the body dry weight, which is approximately about 10 to 12 kg in adults. And when we say adults, we are actually considering somebody who is around 72 to 74 kilogram total body weight. Us pure mein 10 se 12 kilo ka body ka dry weight jo hai, that is from the proteins. Okay, they perform a wide variety of steric and dynamic functions. And again, on this aspect, you are very well aware of the fact ke aapki jo proteins hain, they are making important contribution to determine the structure of the body. So chahe wo skeleton ho, chahe wo cardiac, you know, muscles ho, proteins are there and they are the basic component. In fact, agar hum ek cell ki bhi baat kare, so cell mein bhi jo cell membrane hai, what is it? I mean, it's lipoprotein. The major component is protein. Phir cell ke andar, so protein is making you know, there are microfilaments and all those protein things which provide basic skeleton to the cell as well. So the point is ki jitne bhi aapke body mein jo cell ki composition hai, usse leke tissue, organ, sari composition mein proteins are playing vital role in determining the structural support of the body. And then they are not merely structural things, they also provide important functional component. So they are also very dynamic in their action. They act like enzymes, they act like hormones, clotting factors, receptors. आपको पता है कि जितने भी आपके body में hormones हैं, उनकी एक बड़ी variety proteins है, pure proteins या conjugated type of proteins. You have enzymes, they are also proteins. You have clotting factors. So protein molecules are actually responsible for a lot of functions in your body, because from various discussions in other subjects, you know that there is a cell and then there is a receptor, and some sort of protein binds to the receptor and then it performs the intracellular signaling. So this kind of the first paragraph in protein metabolism chapter gives you a very good idea one more time about the importance of protein, structural as well as functional. About half of the body proteins, predominantly collagen, is present in the supportive tissue, that is skeleton and connective tissue, while the other half is intracellular. Okay, proteins are nitrogen containing macromolecules consisting of amino acids. Now you know this ke protein ka jo basic building block hai wo amino acid hai, aur multiple amino acids combined together to make protein. So there is an amino acid, then there is another amino acid, and multiple amino acids ultimately is what we call the protein setup. Of the 20 amino acids found in the proteins, half can be synthesized in the body, and the ones which can be synthesized in the body are also known as non-essential, and the ones which we have to be taken in diet are called essential. Concept ye hai ki they have to be essentially taken into diet. Inko aapne lazmi taur pe diet pe lena hai. Therefore, they are called essential amino acids. So those which we can produce ourselves in the body are called non-essential, because they are not essential to be taken in diet. Okay? The proteins on degradation, yani tootne par, or tootne ko hum kehte hain proteolysis, they release amino acids. Amino acids not just the structural component of the proteins. Now ye jo baat hamari hai na, ye simple concept hai ki there is an amino acid bond, amino acid peptide bond, amino acid. So when you break it, what will be released? Obviously protein is a chain of amino acids, so when you break it to glucose to nahi niklenge na, protein mein se amino acid hi niklenge. So that's what they are telling. Okay, each one of the 20 naturally occurring amino acids undergo its own metabolism. Sabka metabolic pathway alag alag hai. Some of the amino acids also serve as precursor for synthesis of many other biological compounds such as melanin, serotonin. Abhi hum is chapter mein saari cheeze discuss karenge ki jab amino acid metabolize hote hain to wo kaun sa pathway lete hain. Certain amino acids may directly be used also as neurotransmitters, such as glycine is an amino acid also used as neurotransmitter, aspartate, glutamate. Protein metabolism is more appropriately learned as metabolism of amino acids. So jab main ye heading mere sath ye hua hai past mein ki when I've been through the topic of metabolism of amino acids, mujhse end mein students sawal kar rahe hain ki sir protein ki metabolism kab karwayenge. To mere bhai, protein ki metabolism, amino acid ki metabolism is kind of synonymous with each other. Ek hi cheez hai, theek hai. So amino acid ki metabolism ka matlab aap protein hi ki metabolism study kar rahe hain. Okay, now this kind of the first heading jo hamari aaj ke video ka topic bhi hai, amino acid pool. An adult has about 100 grams of free amino acids which represent the amino acid pool of the body. Okay, ye hota na jaise calcium ka pool hai body mein, bones mein hai, free calcium hai, is tarah amino acid pool bhi hai. The amino acid pool may be an oversimplification of the facts obviously, since there is no single compartment in the body jahan hum kahenge ji bone hai usme calcium pada hua sare ka sara, कि ये पर्टिकुलर कंपार्टमेंट है इसमें सारा अमाइनो एसिड बॉडी का पड़ा हुआ, ऐसा नहीं है. सो दे आर प्रेजेंट इन सेवरल कंपार्टमेंट्स. ग्लूटामेट एंड ग्लूटामिन टुगेदर कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अबाउट 50%. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है यार, इसको जरा गौर से सुनो. ग्लूटामेट एंड ग्लूटामिन टुगेदर कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अबाउट 50% एंड एसेंशियल अमीनो एसिड्स अबाउट 10% ऑफ द बॉडी पूल. और जो कि पूल है कितना टोटल 100 ग्राम. सो दीज आर द मेजर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर्स. द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ इंट्रा सेलुलर अमीनो एसिड इज ऑलवेज हायर देन एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर अमीनो एसिड. सो दे आर मोर इन साइड द सेल एज कम्पेयर टू द आउटसाइड ऑफ द सेल. ओके, अमीनो एसिड्स एंटर द सेल्स अगेंस्ट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट, जिसका मतलब ये है कि दे हैव टू फॉलो द रूट ऑफ एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. इस पूरे जुमले का बेसिकली मतलब ये है कि सपोज ये सेल है, सेल में ऑलरेडी काफी सारे अमीनो एसिड मौजूद हैं. ओके, नाउ इफ द अमीनो एसिड हैव टू बी मूव्ड फ्रॉम द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर कंपार्टमेंट इन साइड द सेल, सो दिस इज यूजली अगेंस्ट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट. यानी इट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम द लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट outside the cell to the high concentration gradient inside the cell. Aur jab kabhi against the concentration gradient movement hoti hai, this is what is known as active transport and ATP will be utilized here. Theek hai, to ye basic concepts hai. The amino acid pool of the body is maintained by the sources that contribute and metabolic pathways that utilize. Obviously dekho, agar main baat kar raha hu ki ye pool hai hamare body mein amino acid ka, to ye depend karta na ki hum kitne amino acid ki input is taraf la rahe hain. Yani what we are eating, for example if we are eating a lot of things, then we are pooling a lot of amino acids, and the consumption part would be the utilization, ki how are they being metabolized. To ye pool ki jo concentration hai uski maintenance depend upon what is the input and then what is the output. Okay, now what are the sources? So here is the diagram which shows also that this is the body amino acid pool, which is about 100 grams. It doesn't look too much, hai na? Thoda sa lagta hai. So kahan kahan wo use hota hai, kya kya sources hain. So let's talk about the sources. We can synthesize the non-essential amino acids. We can also eat. So these are the sources. Jo is taraf arrow aa raha hai, that is the input. So one source, for example, is synthesis inside the body. Other source, for example, is dietary protein. Hum khate hain rozana, gosht kha rahe hain, chicken, dalein, ye sab cheezein. Inme protein hai. So that is about 40 to 100 grams per day. We also have protein breakdown in the body. So that's also an important source which is contributing towards the amino acid pool. So ye teen sources to aapko definitely yaad rakhni hai, the arrows which are coming towards the pool. Okay, the protein breakdown, dietary and synthesis. So the sources of amino acid would be the turnover of body protein, intake of dietary protein and synthesis. So yehi teen sources ho gayi. Dekhen, one is the turnover, which is the breakdown, intake, which is the dietary, and then synthesis. So they all contribute towards the pool of the amino acid in the body. Now, when we talk about protein turnover, yani protein breakdown, the protein present in the body is in a very dynamic state. It is estimated that about 300 to 400 grams of protein per day is constantly degraded and synthesized, which represents the body turnover. So protein degrade ho rahi hai, dobara ban rahi hai, that's the turnover cycle. There is a wide variation in the turnover of individual protein. For instance, the plasma proteins and digestive enzymes are rapidly degraded. Their half-lives are very short, for example, lekin kuch structural proteins hain, unki half-life kafi zyada hai, months and years. And it makes sense. Aap sochein, aapki bone mein jo collagen hai, agar wo har aadhe ghante baad toot raha hota, to aapki bones toot rahi hoti. So that is something which makes sense, perfect sense, ki structural proteins are usually for long time, unka half-life zyada hai. Okay? Now, the turnover of the protein is influenced by a lot of factors. और इस chapter में हम पढ़ेंगे कि ये जो protein की हम degradation और ये सब बातें करते हैं, ये turnover क्या-क्या factors हैं? A small polypeptide known as ubiquitin, ये नाम याद रखें, it's extremely important. It tags the protein and facilitates degradation. यानि अगर ये एक protein मौजूद है मेरी body में और अब इसको फारक करना है मुझे, इसको degrade करना है, तोड़ना है, तो इस पर मुझे एक tag लगाना होता है और वो tag ubiquitin protein का tag है. एक दफा ये tag लग गया तो it goes down to the degradation pathway और ये protein अब फारक हो गई बस, ठीक है? That's one of the mechanisms. Certain proteins with amino acid sequence, proline, glutamine are rapidly degraded as well. So just by the fact that they have proline and glutamine residues, they are degraded more rapidly. Then when we talk about dietary proteins, I told you that we eat a lot of proteins, hai na? Gosht kha rahe hain, cereals hain, to ye zaruri hai body ke nitrogen balance ko maintain rakhne ke liye bhi. And proteins are important part of your balanced diet as well. So we have a lot of proteins daily in our eating. There is a regular loss of nitrogen from the body due to degradation of amino acids. Therefore, to keep up with this pace, 30 to 50 grams of protein is lost every day from the body. Aur itna hi aapko lena bhi chahiye to maintain the nitrogen balance. The purpose of dietary protein is to supply amino acids for the synthesis of protein and other nitrogen compounds. So there is no storage form of amino acid. Therefore, you have to continuously take them. Ye body se release ho rahe hain, breakdown ho rahe hain. So you have to take them. You have to eat them. Okay. And this is in contrast with the carbohydrate, jiska storage form hai glycogen, lipids, jiska storage form hai triacylglycerols. Amino acid ka storage form aapko nahi sunne mein milega. The excess intake of amino acids are metabolized, oxidized to provide energy, converted to glucose or fat as well. So, agar aap bahut zyada protein le rahe hain, to wo bhi glucose or fat mein convert hoti hai ultimately. The amino groups are lost as urea and they are excreted in urine. The protein consumption in developed countries is much higher than the recommended daily dietary allowance, which is about 1 gram per kilogram of the body weight per day. अब डेवलप कंट्रीज हैं, ऑब्वियसली गोश्त वोश ज़्यादा है, चिकन ज़्यादा है, अच्छा खाना खा रहे हैं, तो उनकी प्रोटीन कंजम्पशन काफ़ी ज़्यादा है. द डेली प्रोटीन इनटेक बाय एन एडल्ट इन मोस्ट कंट्रीज इज अबाउट 40 to 100 grams. Protein is digested by enzymes in the body and free amino acids are liberated which contribute to the pool. तो पहला सोर्स था वी टॉक्ड अबाउट प्रोटीन टर्नओवर व्हिच इज डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ द बॉडी प्रोटीन. सेकंड, डायट्री प्रोटीन से आपकी बॉडी में आ रहा है अमीनो एसिड्स. एंड नंबर थर्ड इज यू आर सिंथेसाइजिंग देम. सो 10 आउट ऑफ 20 आर सिंथेसाइज इन द बॉडी, सो दे आर नॉन एसेंशियल अमीनो एसिड्स एंड यू कैन एक्चुअली मेक देम. तो किसी भी पूल का मैंने आपको बताया ना कि देयर इज एन इनपुट, और वो इनपुट का मतलब है कि सोर्सेज क्या क्या हैं. वो तीन सोर्सेज मैंने आपको बता दी, डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ द प्रोटीन, ईटिंग ऑफ द प्रोटीन, एंड नंबर थ्री वॉज सिंथेसिस ऑफ अमीनो एसिड ऑफ नॉन एसेंशियल अमीनो एसिड्स. अब यूटिलाइजेशन एंड पर कहाँ कहाँ ये यूज होते हैं, तो देखें, दे आर यूज, दे आर कन्वर्टेड इन टू अदर कंपाउंड सच एज कार्बोहाइड्रेट, such as pyrimidines. They also contribute to protein synthesis in the body. They also are utilized as source of, so these are the utilization. ठीक है, तो utility of amino acid क्या क्या है? Most of the body proteins degraded are synthesized from the amino acids. So the amino acids are making proteins in your body. Obviously you need to make a lot of proteins. अब वो protein hormone भी हो सकता है, enzyme भी हो सकता है, वो protein structural collagen भी हो सकता है. So they require amino acids. These include enzymes, hormones, ये जो मैं अभी बात आपसे कर रहा था, contractile proteins. All the proteins are actually made up of amino acids. Okay? Then many important nitrogenous compounds are produced from the amino acid. You look at purines, pyrimidines, porphyrins. They are all made up of amino acid. About 30 gram of the protein is daily utilized for making other compounds. then generally about 10 to 15% of the body energy requirements are met from the amino acids. So they are also an important source of energy. Then the amino acids are also converted into other organic compounds, including carbohydrates and fats. So this video, today's video, gives you an overall idea of how the amino acid is handled in the body. What are the input sources? What are the utilization sources? In the next video, I will talk about the general aspects of metabolism of amino acid. There are some terms that you have to learn. Then we will talk about specific amino acids. For example, what is deamination, transamination, things like that. Okay? So, we'll see you in the next video. Take care of yourself.